Good morning. Thank you for coming out to us. My name's Colton.
And I'm Steve. So this morning we got a little lost, got a little tour Cedar Rapids. That was nice. It's kind of difficult finding this place. I'm Stephen Myoffer. I'm a current senior at the University of Iowa. Colton and Jackson, who's our third team member, also is a senior. Colton and I are from the Chicagoland area. Jackson's from Rockford. And we are founding fathers of the Kappa Sigma fraternity here at the University of Iowa. Or not here, but at the University of Iowa. Being a founding father, I had the experience of being the vice president of this chapter for a year and a half. And throughout that year and a half, I don't know about you guys if you have any teachers or professors here, but running a 60-man group, or 60-man deep of 20-year-olds is pretty challenging, pretty difficult to keep everyone on the same page. So throughout this process, so many different obstacles that we had to overcome to become an established chapter, but the biggest one, the thing that we had the biggest problem with was communication. Being a founding father chapter, I thought that, hey, maybe that this was just something that, was only a problem with founding father chapters. So we reached out to 25 other chapter presidents and customer discovery and found this. 44%, almost half, of the chapter presidents that we interviewed found that communication was the biggest debilitating issue with their chapter. So many different things, whether it's events, or recording, anything that it may be, communication was the biggest problem. As you can see, involvement was second on there. Getting chapter members involved in the community, organization, keeping everyone organized. But can't miss it. Communication. 14.
14.
Of these chapter presidents said that communication was the biggest problem.
Going over to my side of the aspect, I am also going to be a senior, but I never held a chair position in Kappa Sigma. So going as an everyday average chapter member, I found myself really disengaged with the community, struggling to find out when and where events were happening, where they would take place. I wouldn't know because of bad promotion and marketing, and also just I would hear word of mouth and I would forget about it a week down the road because there was never any follow-up information. So as you can see, this is how the average chapter member in the fraternity and sorority find out about these events and where they're taking place. Mainly social media, through Facebook, a Facebook group, an event going on, you RSVP, I'm sure many of you have seen these. And then also just more personal texting, your friends, getting the information via phone, and then so on and so forth. Some of the others were just word of mouth, flyers, hearsay, and so on. So with that, we knew that there was a problem. We knew that these events were at a minimal, at the lowest possible productivity that they could have. So we created this solution called Athena, which is going to centralize everything that a chapter president needs to run his business. This is going to be a Greek exclusive platform, centralizing all these tools and tactics that they need, and making the chapter president's life a lot easier.
So Athena, got to work a little bit and put together some screenshots. Now these are mostly stuff that already exists, so you can tell Twitter and Facebook are on there. But what we really are getting at is the calendar. The calendar is our minimal viable product, and we found that out through customer discovery. Calendar is the most efficient way to keep every chapter member informed and up to date about events going on within the chapter and within the community. Every single chapter president that we talked to, when talking about our application, they said, put a calendar on there. The calendar is the key to this, making this work, along with push notifications and other features and bells and whistles that we can get into. But it really comes down to having an interactive calendar that is user-friendly and easy to read. It's going to be the best way to keep everyone informed. So then we start looking about how we're going to make money. So our revenue model. So we're going to be doing a subscription-based model based off of every semester. Depending on the chapter size, it's going to be priced at different ranges. So as you can see, a chapter with about 20 members is only going to pay $50 a semester, while you have a chapter with 175 members paying $1,000 per semester. Now this is based off of other current platforms that are in the market. We'll get into the competitive table a little bit later. But pretty established, and this is all coming out of the chapter's budget, so no members are paying for this out of pocket, all from the chapter's budget, which makes it a little bit more reasonable and just something the chapter can handle. So how are we going to get it out? So grassroots, guerrilla. That's how we're going to attack this. We're going to start at Iowa, and using the social media the way how fast things can get viral, that's going to be our best bet. Reaching out to fraternities all around the country, starting in the Big Ten. Kappa Sigma has 316 chapters throughout the nation, making it, I believe, the second largest, so we have a foothold in a lot of different colleges across the nation, and one easy sell, and then we can really work on that at that campus. So really quickly, we'll go over the market size.
So for our target market, we want to start out at Iowa, as Steve pointed out, but across the nation in the U.S. there are over 13,000 chapters, and with that, roughly at Iowa there's 4,000 kids, so if you do the math, there is quite a market here, although it is very targeted and selected. After that, here's our competitive table. So we base this off of the efficiency and capability. As efficient as Facebook is, and everyone is checking it, you've had a Facebook since you were 8 years ago or whatnot. Everyone's on it, everyone's looking up to date, keeping in tune with what's going on in their lives and their friends. Going over to what the university uses now, OrgSync, the little green half circle, is very inefficient, and although it is capable of a lot, it's very tedious, time constraining, and hard to use. So we want to play both roles of OrgSync and Facebook, combining them, being efficient and capable of everything.
So where do we go from here? So neither of us are tech guys. So our biggest thing and biggest issue that we have is designing and developing this mobile application. After that, we want to focus on social media marketing, which is something that being 20 years old in this day and age is something that will come pretty easy to us.